Just want to thank everybody for coming tonight. You know, without an elected that's informed, this whole process doesn't work. So thank y'all for coming. I wish the place was packed. But, you know, we've got a good crowd tonight. My name's Clay Greiner. Been in Lowndes County my entire life. I graduated from Lowndes High School in 93, graduated from Ballas State in 96 with a finance degree, and being a finance major, I like numbers. And so when I got elected 2 years ago, a little over 2 years ago, I took office and I went down to the county office and said, okay, how can I make a difference? And I started looking at numbers, looking at budgets, looking at things that I enjoy. And, you know, the sheriff's budget came glaring out because it's such a big percentage of our overall budget in the county. And so you start looking at things and, you know, you start looking at the whole process of the criminal justice system and looking at where we spend our money and how efficiently we're spending it. And that's kind of where I started with this process. But once I got into looking, we had about 700 people on average any day in jail. And you know, that equates to about, if you figure Eccles County's population in with ours, somewhere in the 580, 590 people per 100,000, which is 1.7 times the state average of 340, and more than double the national average of 235 per 100,000. So that was, you know, looked like a situation where we might could do, you know, make some changes in the way we do things, make our criminal justice system a little more efficient, and maybe save some money there. And so that's what we started August of 2015. We sat down, myself and Joyce Evans, one of the other county commissioners from District 1, the sheriff, the state court judges, a couple of the superior court judges, the solicitor, the district attorney, several representatives from probation, the clerk of the court, and we sat down and started talking about ideas and things that other counties were doing with their, you know, to try to decrease their jail population, or not just to decrease the jail population, but to make things more efficient from the criminal justice system standpoint itself. And we came up with, over a year's time, we've come up with ideas. One we've already implemented, which is the drug court and the accountability court for the Superior Court, which started back in January this year. This coming January, we'll start a DUI court for the state court system. We've also hired a pre-trial, post-trial coordinator for the state court system. We're implementing a software system for the clerk of the court that's going to integrate all of the courts together and should be able to implement what Justin was talking about earlier. Once we get that in place, traffic violation bureau, which will decriminalize some of the traffic violations, minor traffic violations. And all these things are going to hopefully help us to decrease the jail population, but also at the same time, hopefully it's going to make some of the citizens that are running through the jail process, or running through the criminal justice system now, hopefully some of them will escape that process. You know, the drug courts and the accountability courts, that's what they're designed to do. That's not going to be a silver bullet for everything, and not everybody that goes through the system is going to come out the other side of it. But if some of them do, and we decrease our jail cost, to decrease our jail inmate population, then we move in the right direction. One other thing I want to say real quickly, we're the only county in the state of Georgia that has elected tax assessors. Maybe we're right, maybe we're wrong, I don't know. But it just seems to me, if we're the only one, that we might be doing something better with that. And I appreciate everybody coming tonight, and thank you. My name is Clay Greiner, and I'm running for District 5. County Commission, I'd like to have you vote. Thank you.
Our next candidate for County Commission District 5 is Teresa Moffitt.